Now let's talk about the logarithmic decrement. So this is how very common kind of a displacement time diagram is drawn. So you have this periodic motion shown to you. So let us say at time t1 the displacement is x1, okay, and at time t2 the displacement is x2, okay, and this is the exponential curve which shows that the decrease in the amplitude of a periodic motion is exponential in nature. Alright, so if I have to take the ratio between x1 and x2, so x1 by x2, this is equal to c e to the power minus zeta omega t1 by c e to the power minus zeta omega into t2. I can get rid of c and I will get e to the power zeta omega t2 minus t1. Now this t2 minus t1, this is the time period of oscillation. Okay, so t2 minus t1 is 2 pi upon omega d, which is where omega d is the damping frequency. This is called the time period of oscillation. Alright. So if I substitute this in this equation, I would get x1 by x2, which is e to the power zeta into omega into 2 pi upon omega d. Okay. Now omega by omega d, this is 1 upon under root 1 minus zeta square. So this would be e to the power 2 pi zeta upon 1 minus zeta square. Okay. I can substitute this exponent as delta. So you will have e to the power of delta. So if you take the log of this, so delta is equal to log of x1 by x2. Okay, that is two consecutive displacements on the same side of the mean position line, and this is equal to 2 pi zeta upon 1 minus zeta square. So this is the formula to calculate the logarithmic decrement. Okay, so this is this part, which is 2 pi zeta upon under root 1 minus zeta square. Alright, so this is the formula that you have to remember for calculating the questions on logarithmic decrement. So I hope you understood this. Now let's move on to forced damped vibrations.